गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम, सो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट ब्लड एंड वी केम टू नो दैट इट इज अ फ्लूइड और लिक्विड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, ओके, विच कनेक्ट्स विच इज प्रेजेंट ऑल ओवर अवर बॉडी. देन वी टॉक्ड अबाउट ब्लड वेसल्स, we talked about arteries, we talked about veins, and we talked about capillaries. Okay, then comes heart. That means another and most important organ associated with circulatory system. Okay, so the three things that is associated with the circulatory system was blood, blood vessel, and heart. So as we have discussed about blood and blood vessels, so today we are going to talk about heart. So heart is present at the upper chest or upper above the abdominal, that means in the chest cavity. Okay, as we know that our chest cavity contains lungs and hearts. Okay, heart, lung, as we all know, it is present at the both side, that means left and right side, we have two lungs. Then regarding heart, heart is present at the base of the chest cavity, that means base means at the middle of the chest cavity. Okay, that means you can say that it is inside lungs. Okay, and it is one of the most vital organs which helps the blood to flow, that means it act as a pumping organ. Heart act as a pumping organs, and what does it pump? It pumps blood throughout our body. Okay, and its size is similar to your fist. Fist means mutthi. Okay, the size of a heart is like our fist. Okay, so heart is the most sensitive organ of our body. The heart in our body is located in the chest cavity, that means as I told that it is located in our chest cavity. Okay, and it is one of the most important organ which helps blood to pump to all parts of the body. That means it is a continuous, it continues function, that means it has a continuous work. Okay, that's why a person is said to be dead when that person heart stops working. Okay, that means if heart stops working, then we can say that a person is dead, a person is no more. So for survival, these organ must function properly. This organ, that means heart, must function properly. So if the heart is not functioning properly, it can be said that that person is no more. Okay, so heart have four chambers. It has four chambers, or you can say it is four chamber. So human being's heart is four chamber, that means it has been divided into four parts, it has been divided into four parts, whereas birds have only three chambered heart. Okay, that means it's not that all living creatures heart is four chambered. Okay, so our heart, that means human heart, has four chambered, that means auricles and ventricles, four chambered, right auricle, number one, number two, left auricle, number three, right ventricle, एंड लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल. सो वी हैव फोर चैम्बर्ड हार्ट, राइट ऑरिकल, राइट वेंट्रिकल, लेफ्ट ऑरिकल्स एंड लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल्स. एंड वी हैव अनदर फंक्शन ऑफ ऑरिकल्स, डिफरेंट फंक्शन ऑफ ऑरिकल एंड वेंट्रिकल्स. ऑरिकल्स आर द ब्लड रिसीविंग चैम्बर. सो दीज ऑरिकल्स दे आर ब्लड receiving chambers and ventricles are blood giving chambers. Okay, that means blood receiving chambers and blood giving chambers means, as we all know, heart pumps the blood. So to pump the blood we need the receiving point and the what you can say, the removing point also. So auricles helps the blood to receive from other parts of the body, that means deoxygenated blood, that means carbon rich blood, whereas ventricles, they give blood from the heart. That means ventricles, when the blood is oxygenated, okay, they are oxygenated mostly in ventricles, and from ventricles only this blood remove from the heart. The blood is removed from the heart, or blood is supplied, a blood is blood supplying chamber, blood giving or blood supplying chamber. So basically we have four parts of our heart: right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle, left ventricle. Auricle's function is to receive the blood from the different parts of the body, and ventricles, its function is to supply blood, that means to give blood from the heart to different parts of our body. Okay, then we have the upper two chambers are the auricles. Okay, the upper two chambers are auricles. That means you can say that if this is heart, upper two chambers are auricle and lower two chambers are ventricles. So this is left auricle, left ventricle, right ventricles. Okay, so upper two chambers are auricles and lower two chambers are ventricles. Okay, so the upper two chambers have a thin wall and receive blood from different parts of the body. So there is a thin wall, and that means this partition is very thin. Okay, it is very thin, so that the blood can be received and blood can be supplied to different parts of our body. And the lower two chambers are ventricle. Okay, from ventricle blood is pumped out of the heart. So another one, a muscular wall separates the left side of the heart from the right side. Okay, so the blood cannot go from one auricle to another and one ventricle to another. That means the separates left side and right side. That means there is a thin wall, okay, which separates left side and right side. That means left auricle with right auricle, left ventricle with right ventricles, like a thick muscular wall. Okay, and thus this partition wall receive prevents mixing of oxygen rich blood to carbon dioxide rich blood. That means they prevent the mixing. Okay, they prevent the mixing, they act as a barrier. Okay, then let's talk about two important points. The blood flows from the right auricle to the ventricle through valves. These valves between right auricle and right ventricle, okay, right auricle and right ventricle, is called tricuspid valve. That means the valve which separate like opposite valve divides right auricle and right ventricle. Divides right auricle and right ventricles. Okay, so tricuspid valve divides right auricles and right ventricles, whereas bicuspid valve divides left auricle and left ventricle. So basically we have tricuspid valve which divides right auricle and right ventricle, and bicuspid valve which divides left auricle and left ventricle. That means this is tricuspid valve and this is bicuspid valve. Okay, tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve. Okay, so this is the basic structure of heart. This is all basic structure of heart. So by this we can say that heart is divided into four chamber, auricles and ventricles. Auricles are blood receiving chambers, whereas ventricles are blood giving chambers, a blood supplying chambers. And tricuspid valve divides right auricles with right ventricle, and bicuspid valve divides left auricle and left ventricle. And auricles and ventricles, they are also divided by a muscular wall which prevents the oxygen rich blood and the carbon dioxide rich blood in mixing. That means it doesn't let oxygen rich blood and carbon dioxide rich blood to mix. So basically fourth chambered heart is present in our heart is four chambered. Okay, left auricle, left ventricle, right auricle, right ventricle. Okay, now let's talk about how blood circulates in our body. Circulation of blood. So as discussed already that auricles are blood receiving chambers. Okay, auricles are blood receiving chamber. So what happens, all the blood which is after the process of burning of food, okay, after the process of burning of food in the blood, we get energy, and after getting energy, carbon dioxide is present in the blood, and that carbon dioxide should be removed from our body. So heart helps to pump this carbon dioxide rich blood from the heart through ventricles. Okay, so the impure blood from different parts of the body enters the right auricle. That means impure blood enters the right auricle first of all. impure blood enters right auricles. As we all know, auricle is blood receiving chambers. Okay, first of all, it enters the right auricle. Impure blood means the blood which contains carbon dioxide. Okay, from different parts of the body to right auricles and send it to the right ventricles. When it reaches the right auricle, it sends it to the right ventricle. That means it passes the blood to from auricles to ventricles, from auricles to ventricles. Okay, so from here the blood is pumped through pulmonary artery to the lungs for reoxygenated. That means it is sent to pulmonary artery. Okay, pulmonary artery to reoxygenate, that means to purify, So in lungs, this blood gives us carbon dioxide and absorbs oxygen from the inhaled air. That means here, impure blood, that means carbon dioxide rich blood, it enters in the right auricle, then it enters to the right ventricle. In right ventricle, it goes to pulmonary artery. Okay, and pulmonary artery is attached to blood vessels. Blood vessels, which is connected to lungs. That means alveoli. Okay, where exchange of gases takes place. Okay, heart is not directly connected to the exchange of gases. First of all, air that we inhale, okay, inhale is absorbed by our lungs, where in alveoli the exchange of gases takes place in the blood vessel. Okay, so pulmonary artery contains deoxygenated blood, which is sent in blood vessel alveoli. Here these alveoli, they send again after the oxygen is fulfilled. That means when it is reoxygenated, when the blood is reoxygenated, it again sent to pulmonary artery. Okay, so inhaled air, this oxygenated blood returns to the left auricle. Okay, this oxygenated blood returns to the left auricle. Left auricle through pulmonary vein. Through what? Through pulmonary vein. Okay, and regarding arteries and vein, we already know that arteries carries deoxygenated blood and vein carries oxygenated blood. So when the blood is oxygenated, it is received by the pulmonary vein, which sent it to left auricle. Okay, through pulmonary veins, and then enters the left ventricles, and from left auricles it enters to left ventricle. It moves towards left ventricle. From here the blood is pumped through aorta to different parts of the body. Okay, after left ventricle, the blood is pumped through aorta. To different parts of our body. That means oxygenated blood is sent from aorta. Okay. So as the blood passes through the capillaries, oxygen and other nutrients are delivered to the cells, and carbon dioxide and other waste are picked up by the blood. So the carbon dioxide rich blood goes back to the right auricle. That means this process keeps on going. Okay. So blood circulations takes place in our heart when impure blood enters the right auricle. Okay. Then from right auricle it enters the right ventricles. Then in right ventricle the deoxygenated blood is sent to lungs by pulmonary artery. Okay. And as we all know, the artery carries deoxygenated blood. So here after it is oxidized, it is sent to pulmonary vein. Okay. From where it is sent to left auricles, then left ventricle. After left ventricle, those oxygenated blood, it is passed through different parts of our body through aorta. Okay. And when it is sent to different parts of the body, again it get nutrients, again food is burned, again the blood is deoxidized, that means carbon dioxide is produced in the blood. Same process continues. That means again it goes to auricles, then ventricles, then pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein, sorry, between pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein, the exchange of gases takes place in lungs. Okay. Then left auricle, left ventricle, and again back to different parts of our body. Okay. So this was all about heart and circulation of blood.